God's good. Wow. What is wrong? Amen. God's good.
Yeah.
Yes.
Woo.
That's what we're saying.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Now, we were down in Knoxville last night. Let me tell you, we'd be making more racket than that, wouldn't we? And who we serve is a whole lot more important than football.
Hallelujah.
Stand up a little bit.
Amen.
Let's get our mind on God and let's worship.
Yes.
We can get up here and play music all night. But if we don't worship God, we've not accomplished nothing but put on the show.
That's right.
Let's get our heart on Him. Let's
praise
love
the
Him.
Lord.
Oh,
his holy name. Praise the Lord. Next one, I'd like to say this right quick, that there's so many people in the world, all over the world, that feel so unloved. You know that? Have you ever felt unloved yourself? I have. I guess we all have. And, you know, some people get stuck in that and stay in that. Some people never really feel loved. But if they could find Jesus, they would find love, wouldn't they? Because no greater love has any man that he'd lay down his life for us, and he did, didn't he? He laid down his precious life.
Amen. God's good.
Hallelujah.
You know that other song? That concept may be a little bit alien to a lot of you. But I believe that the Lord sings over us. I believe that with all my heart. And he might be singing something like this. My children love me. Can you see them worship? My children love me. Can you see them? They're adoring me. And he sings of mercy, songs of grace that he sings over us. And do you know that when we worship God, when our heart gets into pure worship, that the angels are released to do miracles in this earth? So when we fail to praise him, when we fail to worship, we're tying the angels' hands, guys. And we're in his house today. And the Lord has really been dealing heavily with me this week on some things. That as a church body, we need to learn to worship God. We don't just come in here and watch Miriam play such a wonderful job on the flute and sing wonderful songs. We don't come in here just to hear David get up here and open up, or us to get up here and do some crazy things. We don't just come in here to hear me get up here and tell you some story and preach for 10 minutes. But we come here to worship God. And if our focus is on anything other than worshiping God, we're missing the boat, guys. I don't want you to feel like we're putting on a concert every Sunday. Please don't feel that way. But I want your heart to be in tune with his heart. I want your joy to be full because he gave it to you. I want you to worship him because of who he is and what he's done for you. My gosh, he walked to a cross. He gave his life for us. Can we not, for an hour and a half on Sunday morning, get beyond all the junk that we've got just crammed in our head and focus upon him and worship him as Lord of Lords, of King of Kings, as our Savior, our Redeemer? Can we be mindful of him this morning? Can we get our mind off of, man, we're going to go pig out after a while, or who's going to send me a text, or what am I going to do after a while? He is worthy, guys. He's the only one that's worthy. We're going to do this song. And I ask you to let your heart lead this room this morning. And get into that throne room with God.
Hallelujah.
And worship him. Amen. And he deserves to be worshipped.
He does. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. see it.